हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हम लोग फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ डाइजेशन की स्टडी कर चुके हैं और हमें पता है कि एलिमेंट्री कैनाल में फूड का डाइजेशन कैसे होता है। अब हमारा नेक्स्ट जो टॉपिक है वो है न्यूट्रिशनल अपटेक एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ दीज डाइजेस्टेड फूड मटेरियल, कि हमारी एलिमेंट्री कैनाल में जो फूड का डाइजेशन होता है और एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस डाइजेशन एंड प्रोडक्ट्स आर फॉर्म एंड हाउ दीज एंड प्रोडक्ट्स आर एब्जॉर्ब इन अवर बॉडी। ओके, नाउ what is nutrition? Nutrition is a process by which plants and animal takes in and utilize food material, while the nutrients are material which constitute food and are very essential for the survival of living being. What is food? Food is nutritive substance taken by living organisms for growth, work, repair and maintenance of life processes. In other words, food is kind of fuel for our body. Function of food in our body is to provide energy which is needed to maintain body heat and perform the daily vital activities. Vital activities मतलब जो activities जीने के लिए ज़रूरी होती है, to provide material for growth of the body, to regulate body processes, to maintain life, to make new material necessary for reproduction, to help in respiration, to help in repairing the damaged cell of the various tissues in the body and to help in removal of waste material from our body. What are the main components of food? Major components of our food are carbohydrate, oil and fat, proteins, minerals, vitamins and water. The nutrients may also be classified into three types. Energy providing food are rich in carbohydrate and fat. Bodybuilding food are rich in proteins and protective foods are rich in vitamins, proteins and minerals. अब हम next slide में ये पढ़ेंगे कि किस तरीके से जो food material का जब digestion होता है तो उनके जो end products होते हैं उनको body में किस mechanism के through एब्जॉर्ब किया जाता है। जैसा कि हमने पहले भी हम पढ़ चुके हैं कि कार्बोहाइड्रेट का जो एंड प्रोडक्ट होता है वो मोनोसैकेराइड्स होते हैं, प्रोटीन्स के एंड प्रोडक्ट अमीनो एसिड्स होते हैं और फैट्स लिपिड्स के फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल होते हैं। नाउ वी कम टू अवर मेन टॉपिक, दैट इज़ न्यूट्रिशनल अपटेक। डाइजेस्टिव प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट, फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन आर एब्जॉर्ब इन द इंटेस्टाइन एंड रीचेस टू डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ बॉडी थ्रू ब्लड सर्कुलेशन। मीन्स ब्लड प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। Absorption is a process by which the end product of the digestion are transported from the lumen of alimentary canal to the bloodstream through the intestinal wall. An alimentary canal consists of mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. Small intestine is again divided into three parts, that is duodenum, jejunum and ileum, while the large intestine is divided into two parts, rectum and colon. Now, food is not at all absorbed in the mouth. Simple substances in a small amount get absorbed in the stomach. These are water, alcohol, salt, glucose and easily diffusible drugs. Small intestine is a main part of our gastrointestinal tract where most of our nutrient absorption takes place. Everything we eat and drink throughout the course of a day will make its way through the small intestine which will absorb the nutrients and distribute them to the body. Means जो main place है food के absorption का वो small intestine है और वहाँ से ही small intestine के द्वारा food material को absorb किया जाता है और पूरी body में blood circulation के through distribute किया जाता है। Small intestine consists of three parts, duodenum, jejunum and ileum. The duodenum is the initial portion of the small intestine and is where absorption actually begins. The jejunum is a middle section of the small intestine. It has a lining which is designed to absorb carbohydrate and proteins. The villi in the jejunum are much longer than in the duodenum and ileum. The ileum is the final section of the small intestine. The function of ileum is mainly to absorb vitamin B12, bile salts and many of the products of digestion that were not absorbed. The entire small intestine contains villi in most higher vertebrate. These are broad leaf-like and numerous at the upper end of the intestine and more longer and more finger-like farther along. Villi increases the absorptive area of the small intestine by contracting and relaxing. They facilitate the emptying of the lac tails that are within them. Now we come to the uptake and distribution of carbohydrate. The end product of carbohydrate digestion is monosaccharide. These are glucose, galactose, fructose, mannose and pantose. Glucose and galactose are absorbed much more rapidly than the fructose, mannose and pantose. In the absorption of glucose and galactose, active transport is involved. Means this process takes place in the presence of एनर्जी. ग्लूकोज फ्रॉम द ल्यूमन ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन वेंट्स इनटू द पोर्टल सिस्टम मींस वीनस सिस्टम ऑफ द ब्लड. मोनोसेक्राइड्स आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड वाया द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइनल वॉल टू द साइटोप्लाज्म फ्रॉम वेयर दे डिफ्यूज इनटू द पोर्टल सिस्टम. द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ इंटेस्टाइनल वॉल हैज कैरियर प्रोटीन्स कॉल्ड SDLTs, सोडियम डिपेंडेंट ग्लूकोज ट्रांसपोर्टर्स. द कैरियर प्रोटीन हैज टू बाइंडिंग साइन, वन फॉर ग्लूकोज एंड अनदर फॉर सोडियम. इट बाइंड्स विद सोडियम एंड ग्लूकोज, देन द कैरियर प्रोटीन्स मूव्स टुवर्ड द साइटोप्लाज्म ऑफ द सेल. हियर बोथ glucose and sodium release. Glucose moves along the cytoplasm, diffuses into the blood. Thus, sodium is transported back into the lumen of gut through sodium-potassium pump. The simultaneous transport of sodium and potassium, sodium and glucose, is called co-transport. As sodium and glucose are transported simultaneously in the same direction, it is also called symport. SGLT transport galactose also. Fructose is transported by the carrier protein GLUT, means glucose transporter. The carrier for fructose is independent of sodium. The transport of fructose is much slower. The absorption of carbohydrate is controlled by the following factor. These factors are complete digestion of carbohydrate, presence of phosphoric acid and phosphokinase enzyme, adrenal cortex, anterior pituitary, insulin, B complex vitamin like thiamine, pantothenic acid and the pyridoxines. Now, nutritional uptake and distribution of protein. As you know, the end product of protein digestion is amino acid. Amino acid is actively transported into the cytoplasm of small intestine, from where it enters into the portal system of blood. Jejunum part of small intestine is mainly involved in the absorption of amino acid, although a small amount of amino acid get absorbed in the ileum. Carrier protein present in the plasma membrane of small intestine has two binding sites, one for amino acid and other for sodium ion. It binds with amino acid and sodium, both get released into the cytoplasm, from where they diffuse into the portal system of the blood. Transport of amino acid takes place against concentration gradient. Dear students, as you know, there are two types of amino acids, L form and D form. L form of amino acid absorb rapidly and actively, while the D forms are transported slowly and passively. 7 carrier systems are involved in the transport of protein. There are separate transport system for different type of amino acids. Now, we come to the nutritional uptake and distribution of lipids. The end product of lipid digestion are fatty acid and glycerol, triglyceride, diglyceride, monoglyceride, phospholipids, cholesterol and cholesterol esters. Absorption of digested product of lipid occur in small intestine. Transportation of lipid takes place through two mechanisms, that is through portal venous system and through lacteals. Free fatty acid less than 12 carbon atom are absorbed in the portal blood, while more than 12 carbon atom, means from 14 carbon atom or more, are absorbed through the lacteals and passed into the thoracic duct. As you know, building block of fatty acids are acetyl coenzyme A, which is of 2 carbon atom. Bile salt secreted from liver is stored in gallbladder. Sodium taurocholate and sodium glycolate play important role in the absorption of lipid. Bile salt act as carrier of lipids. Bile salts in the presence of lecithin interact with fatty acid and monoglyceride to form minute complexes called micelles. Micelles are water soluble. The micelles make the lipid soluble and transfer them to the brush border of the intestinal cell. On contact with the cell surface, the bile salts separate from the lipid portion. The lipid portion passively diffuse through the plasma membrane and enters the cytoplasm. The separated bile salts move into the lumen and transport more fatty acid and monoglycerides into the brush border. The micelles move down along the concentration gradient to the mucosal surface. Free cholesterol formed from cholesterol ester by the action of esterases enter the cell and re-esterified. The lipid reaches through the venous blood through two routes, the venous portal blood and lacteals. Most of the short chain fatty acid having 12 or less than 12 carbon atom and glycerol of the mucosal cell diffuse into the portal blood. Long chain fatty acid having more than 12 carbon atom of the mucosal cell are resynthesized into the triglyceride. This synthesis occurs in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The resynthesized triglyceride and the absorbed phospholipid, cholesterol, cholesterol ester, free fatty acid with more than 12 carbon atom and fat soluble vitamins are all combined with proteins in the cisternae of endoplasmic reticulum to form large lipoprotein particles called chylomicrons. They enter the lacteals of the villus to be transported via the lymph to the thoracic duct and finally reaches the venous blood. The chylomicron do not enter into the portal blood directly. Now, we come to the end of our topic, that is almost up to the 80% of water in our body is absorbed by the small intestine, as well as electrolyte like chloride, potassium and sodium ion channels will be crucial in replenishing and driving this life sustaining process. Likewise, a small intestine has an important role of absorbing vitamins and minerals from our diet. Fat soluble vitamin A, D, E, K are absorbed by simple diffusion along with dietary fat. Meanwhile, water soluble vitamin B and C will be absorbed by the facilitated diffusion, as their hydrophilic nature demonstrates their simple entry into our cell. In this way, nutritional uptake and distribution of digested food material takes place in our body. Dear students, I hope aapko ye video bahut pasand aayega. Thank you.